Hey, welcome back to Who Me Be a Leader. And as we continue our walk, Biblical Counseling Framework for Life, we've been dealing with a lot about guilt, judgment, fleeing. Remember those three: guilt, judgment, fleeing, because that's what comes up on you when you don't act, when you don't act accordingly, when you find sin up on you. The fact is that when you don't confess it and repent, what it does, it causes a sense of guilt. And remember, we talk about there's no such thing as false guilt. And then when you continue in it, what it does is it give you a fear of God's judgment. And then as you continue, what you begin to do is to flee. Remember, we talked a lot about Adam and Eve in the garden and what happened with them. They made some wrong choices that brought about some serious negative consequences. And we've all been there before, that we made some bad decision that brought negative consequences. Because it's not really God that's judging us, because the judgment come later. What it is the decisions that we made that causes us to begin to feel a sense of guilt, and then it causes us to feel his judgment, and then we begin to flee. And we're not necessarily fleeing by running physically. What we're doing, sometimes we're fleeing in our heart and we're fleeing in our mind, and sometimes it can be physical. But what we want to do today, we want to examine a proverb that I think is near and dear to me, because we used it quite a bit when we was in biblical counseling, and it's Proverbs 28:1, and I want to read it to you, Proverbs 28:1, because it shows a serious contrast between wicked and boldness. Wicked and bold, because it's hard to be bold when you violated either your moral standard or either God's standard. It's hard to be bold because you know you got something going on, and so we find it hard to step out for the simple reason, because we're always afraid that somebody gonna see us. One of the things that I want to say, just from a personal standpoint, when I find myself in that, it's not hard for me to step out, for the simple reason because I know the choice that I made it of my own accord. Nobody forced me to do it. And I began to put in place in categories in my mind and begin to talk to myself and say, "Rob, you made that decision, and that's why you reaping what you sow." And that's what we have to understand. The reaping sowing process is a serious one. Remember, he said, "God would not be mocked. Whatever a man sow, he will reap it." And so Proverbs 28 shows a serious contrast. And look at what it's saying. It says, "The wicked flee when no one is pursuing, but the righteous is bold as a lion." Now let's examine that first part, because that first part is serious. We're talking about wicked. And now we're not talking about a person per se wicked. We're talking about they've done some wicked things. And that's why I always tell you, be careful of telling your kid how good they are. Tell them that they've done some good things, because a kid can grow up thinking that they're better than somebody else. That I'm good. And then what happened, it devastates them when they find themselves doing something that they know goes against what you say their goodness are. And that's what's the struggle. We got a lot of people struggling because they basically think that they're good people, because they examine themselves up to some sinful person or something that they know that other people are doing, and they say to themselves, "Well, at least I'm not doing that," because the word "at least" can make you feel good about yourself, man. And I'm telling you that, hey, at least nothing, because the fact is God say all sin is filthy as rags, and that's what he said. And so when we look at that word Proverbs, and the wicked is referring to a person who's not living their life according to God's standard, who's not living, and we're talking about going against God. The wicked flee when no one pursuing, because a lot of times when we've done something that nobody knows about and we know about, sometime in our mind we begin to think that they know, because they might start acting a certain way, and we think that they own to us, that they know something. We be speculating and going on, and we begin to flee. And part of that fleeing is we stay away from that person. We stay away from the church. We stay away from God's people, because guess what? God always have a way of saying something to make you think that them people know. Now you got to remember, God already knows, so you ain't hiding from him. You hiding from the people, and that's what I'm saying. You hiding from the people, and God is saying that, hey, all you have to do is confess and repent. 1 John 1:9. Remember, I told you, confession is not for God. He already know what's going on with you. confess it is you, so you can unload yourself, so you can run with the freedom that Christ has come to set you free from. Because that's the reason why a lot of us can't counsel one another. Because I believe that the Bible is sufficient for all things, and it gives each one of us the ability to be able to counsel one another. But what happened is we're not studying to show ourselves approved. Workmen need not be ashamed, can rightly divide the word of God. And what happens is, that's why we have to go outside of the family a lot of time to get counseling. Now, don't misunderstand me. There's nothing wrong with going to counseling, because a lot of times we don't know everything, and somebody gonna always know more than you. So there's nothing wrong with going out there. But what I'm saying is, if we really begin to embrace God's word, get into it, let it get into us, we can have the ability to counsel one another. Remember, the wicked flee when no one is pursuing. And so what we're talking about, not a person being wicked. We're not calling a person wicked. What we're saying is that they are violating God's standard. Now, the other part of that scripture said what? But the righteous is as bold as a lion. The righteous is as bold as a lion. We always talk about the lion is the king of the jungle. So we know that a lot of the animals in the jungle fear him. And so what I'm saying is, sometimes you can stand up like you just got it going on, but it's not really you. It's just that you know that you're walking upright with God. And so what happened is, his boldness shined through you, and it makes it look like you. And people begin to say, man, that dude got it going on. And let me tell you something. When you're walking bold with God, let me tell you, nobody can touch you. I don't care who they are. Can't nobody touch you. And I'm saying to you that that's the way God wants us dealing. He wants us to draw near to him as he draws near to us. And then what happens is, he gives us that confidence to walk with boldness. Because let me tell you something. I want you to think about this. Think about when you've done something right, how good that makes you feel. It makes you feel good, man. You can't help but feel good. Now I want you to take it a step further. Think about when you know you're walking upright with God. It's best that you know how, based on your understanding what God has called you to do. That's boldness. Because you can walk like that. You can walk because you know you're doing what the Almighty God has called you to do. And that's what I'm saying. Listen at what Proverbs 14 and 26 say. Because it's talking about God's children. Because he said that, listen at this. The fear of the Lord is, verse 26. Look, the fear of the Lord is their strong, is strong confidence. And his children find refuge. The fear of the Lord is strong confidence. And his children find refuge. Remember, I always say to you, everybody is God's creation, but everybody ain't his child. See, the only people that's going to find strong confidence in the Lord is his children. It's his children. Let me tell you something. You can't be outside the kingdom and find strong confidence in God. Because remember, the Bible said, 1 Corinthians, those who don't know him, it's like a natural man, and whatever God says is foolishness to him. Because you have to know the Almighty God. You have to have a relationship with him through Jesus Christ. And that's what I want to challenge you to do. If you're not there, I want to challenge you to get there. Because not only that, Romans 10:9-10 talks about that. I'm going to challenge you to read that. If you don't feel like you're saved, I want you to go there. Because let me tell you something. All this stuff that I'm talking to you on this blog, it's not going to make any sense to you unless you have a relationship with God and through Jesus Christ. And so that's what I want you to know. So that's why I want to talk to you about this, about Proverbs, because that's a contrast, a great contrast to it. And I wanted you to see that, because the wicked flee with no one pursuing, but the righteous is as bold as a lion. Hey, I'm so excited about this one, because let me tell you something. That is a great contrast, and I want you to challenge yourself to that. But most of all, what I want you to do is I want you to keep that framework close to you. Remember, it leads to a sense of guilt. And from the sense of guilt, it leads to a fear of judgment. And then the fear of judgment leads to you fleeing. I want you to keep that. Always measure yourself up to that framework, because all that you are your thoughts, words, and action. You're going to either be fleeing in your thoughts, or either in your words and what you're saying, or either in your actions. So until I see you next time, may God bless you and keep you is our prayer. And remember, examine your life so you can balance your life. God bless you.